A very good day to you. This is the second session. We're going to make an introduction to you regarding the IPC CID Plus, which is the Advanced PCB Designer course. So before we can take this course, one of the prerequisites that you must have is the IPC CID, which is the basic entry level. So assuming that you already have this, then we're going to discuss or let you know what's the content and what to expect. So first thing is, when you attend CID, normally what happens is they give you just direct information or just straightforward information, but they didn't really tell you how to select or how to evaluate things like material properties or maybe things like methods. So in the CID Plus, what happens is that what we'll be giving you will be more in-depth information. In-depth information as in we explain to you how you can evaluate and what sort of methods you can use in order to, if you see here, how you can choose your materials for your laminate and how you can look at your board properties in order to design your PCB such that it's optimal design. So then if you see, we will talk about electrical and physical properties in detail that relates to design in electrical and design in thermal. So these are what I'll say is a lot more in-depth information. Okay, next thing that is a little bit more in IPC CID Plus is this signal integrity part, whereby we will teach or give the participants the impedance control calculation. We'll show them how we derive impedance in the PCB board design. And we talk about how you can minimize crosstalk, have shielding for EMI and EMC by using the PCB physical structures. Like for example, shielding, we can achieve them by using copper planes like VCC and ground. So the structure and the stack up. So these are a little bit more detailed. In addition, we have also important information about manufacturing in terms of sampling concept. Like for example, how the sampling is being made and quality life cycle in terms of QC and QA. So again here, these are a little bit extra on top of the CID that you have attended. Okay, next thing is we like to let you know that sometimes CID Plus, it seems, or the CID Plus certification is a little bit more valuable, as in not all of the designers who have CID will ultimately achieve a CID Plus, because I would say that the course is slightly more intensive, as in pre-study is highly recommended. It means that you must have enough time to self-study at home, right, before you come to the workshop. And because the workshop, there are many information which is new and it may be kind of hard to digest. So pre-study is one of the highly recommended things that you have to do. And maybe only about 20% of the CID who have attended and they took the course, out of all the CID participants, only maybe about 20% will have a CID Plus. So in terms here, the CID Plus certification is not a lot, but it means that it's much more valuable. And finally, what we like to say is that this is for yourself who is going to take this course, is a verification of all these advanced topics and subjects, and it will help you design, like for example, high speed boards or RF boards that you need to look at shielding and EMI. So getting an introduction into these advanced topics could definitely help you in designing optimal boards. So again, thank you very much for your time and maybe see you next time.